Hello, hello, Gabriel and Nassif for ChannelFireball.com, and today I'm going to be drafting Ultimate Masters UMA. Some of you might have read the article I wrote about. I tried to describe most of the UMA archetypes, and today I'm going to do a little draft. I've enjoyed the format a lot. I think most people have. I'm not sure exactly where it ranks in those kind of master sets history, but it's been fun. And while I think some color combinations might be a bit better than others, I think you can still draft pretty much any color combo and do well if you're in the right seat. And I feel like they did a pretty good job at balancing the set. I don't know exactly how much they test these sets, it turned out okay. It's pretty fun. You usually end up with enough playables, always at least a reasonable deck. I've really liked blue red so far. It's kind of always the same deck. Based around like Thermal Alchemist and some looting effects. Hopefully you get a few Reckless Swarm, a few Fiery Temper. If you're lucky, you get uncommons like Young Pyromancer to make the deck better. I've also liked the green decks based around Kodoma's Reach. So ideally you get 3 or 4 Kodoma's Reach, usually blue-green or black-green based, and then you get to splash flash for what you need. You can play Reanimator decks. The beatdown decks are pretty good as well. The red decks. I haven't drafted the aggro decks as much, but just pretty interesting format in general. I think it's kind of cool that there's Reanimate, for instance. There's not a lot, there hasn't been very many sets, if anywhere, you could like reliably draft reanimate strategies. That's because you have Resurrection at common and you have a bunch of looting effects in pretty much every color. So that's good. 5 in the queue, a 6. I was checking out the Phantom draft just before I got into the real read card draft. Phantom draft had, I was the first person in the queue, so I figured I'd go. I've been playing all my draft in real money draft, even though the value is not probably not great, but I was doing okay, so I was winning packs and just buying in was packs and few ticks. But 5 in the queue, looks like it could be a while, so little intro here. So I guess I'll go through the archetypes, try and go through every color combo for those of you who didn't read the article. So let's start with white-green. White-green is usually heroic-based, like usually white-green aggro. Heroic mechanism. Cards like Phalanx, Wingsteed Rider, Conviction is pretty strong. It's the aura that you can bounce your hand, so you get to trigger heroic a bunch of times. All the green decks obviously can make good use of Mongrel, whether you're an aggro strat. Or even just a controlling strat is still a good 2-drop. Just such a good card. Can be a decent blocker as well. White-green, then there's red-green is the other green base aggro strat. Red-green might be the deck that needs the green combination that needs Mongrel the most. I haven't been super impressed with red-green, but it's a lot of small sample size. Lots of these archetypes I've only drafted once or twice, except for blue-red, which I've drafted a bunch because I thought it was pretty strong and Those are usually pretty open as well. So you've got white green, you've got red green, then you've got what I said about blue green and black green, which was usually the Kodoma's Reach deck. Usually don't want to be blue green aggro or black green aggro. I mean, sometimes it ends up this way, you know. Basically any green deck, if you get your hands on like 4 or 5 Wildmongers and 3 or 4 Basking Rootwallas, there's gonna be a chance that you end up with kind of a beat down deck. Green decks, then you have the blue decks, you have blue red, which I've already talked about, so blue red spells. At common you have Thermal Alchemist and Fire Ice, that are two commons that are pretty much exclusively blue red cards. Thermal Alchemist can be played in red black, and Fire Ice can always be played in any red or blue deck, but they're not as good and won't be picked as high, so you should get your hands on them if you're the only blue red drafter. Then you've got blue white. Blue white is, to give you an idea, the uncommons are Reviving Vapors and Iridescent Drake. So it's, you can draft it in like kind of control-ish way. Vapors into Treasure Cruise is kind of nice. You can have synergies with Flight of Fancy and Iridescent Drake. And what else? Just kind of, yeah, blue white kind of it's usually going to be kind of a control-ish deck. Or basically every white deck, just like every green deck, can end up being a Wildmonger deck. I guess every white deck can always end up being some kind of heroic white base deck. So you could end up being blue, white splashing blue, just a bunch of heroics, and you're playing the blue cards just to trigger your rare cards. Blue red, blue white, and blue black. Blue black I drafted once. I wasn't impressed, despite the fact I had Liliana of the Veil and all this does, but it didn't go away. Anyways, jump into the draft and get some good cards already. Got a Talrand, Sky Summoner, which I've only had once, but I don't think I've ever cast it. You've got Boar Umbra on common, which I'm not a super big fan of. I don't think the Umbras are especially great. This one's okay. I think Snake Umbra, which is +1/+1, draw a card, totem armor, is better than Boar Umbra. Living Lore, which was a bit bugged, was very nice for a while. Not that great. And Phalanx Leader, pretty strong if you're white-based, but I think I'm just going to play Talrand. Seems just very strong and probably in the best archetype. So I think I'm just gonna go with that and probably end up blue red or blue black. We shall see. Gamble, the rare, not especially a playable card, but I guess with flashback cards and stuff you can get some value. If you ever draft like Seismic Assault, Life from the Loam, these two cards are rare, you never know. Could be pretty sweet. So Magma, not especially good in blue red. You don't really have permanents to sack, and 4/4/4/5 is not a great rate. Spirit Cairn, discards a card, you may pay white. This is for both player. This card's kind of good. So I could take Wild Mongrel. The problem is if I end up blue green, I'm gonna make very poor use of Tolerant Sky Summoner. Problem is that if I don't take Mongrel, the other cards are super underwhelming. Skullkeeper is not a great card. Soulsfire is kind of medium in blue-red. I could take Scuzz back if I really want to be blue-red for sure, but I think I'm just going to take Mongrel and see what happens. There's a Wingsteen Rider too. Could be reasonable, but I think Mongrel is a better card. So, but I'm probably... I could be blue-green, I guess. Just trigger Skyron Seminar was Pulse of Murasa, actually. There's a Pulse of Murasa, which is the reprint. Well, I guess all these cards are reprint. And you also have Archaeomancer in blue, which is kind of the archivist. So that's like a loop you see some decks make good use of. Fire and Ice is in the pack. good if I end up being blue-red, also good if I end up being really any color combo, or I could end up some kind of a blue-green slash red deck. I'm just gonna take fire and ice, pick that makes the most sense. Think Twice is a bit slow, not that it formats is always super fast, but I haven't been playing Think Twice too much. It's an interesting pack. There's a Treasure Cruise, which is good, but I don't think you should value it too highly because it's common and you usually don't want to play more than one, and you should always get your hands on one. The Pilgrim, I wonder if there was a Pilgrim in the last pack. The Pilgrim is very strong common because Fae Fetters is common, so being able to tutor for Fae Fetters is pretty absurd. You got double Scuzz back, which is kind of whatever. I'm actually going to take Termo like Expanse here. There's little mana fixing, and Expanse is pretty important. Even if you're only playing two color, there's a bunch of double colored 3 and 4 mana casting cards, so your mana's not always going to eat your pants. This pack's unexciting. I think it's pretty easy Expanse. And wow, Young Pyromancer. We actually have both. We have the common one, which when you play blue-red, you probably play as many as you get. You know, probably could see. I think the max I've had is 4, but I could see playing 5 or 6. Maybe I've had a deck with 6. And Young Pyromancer, which is kind of the nuts in the archetype, which I'm gladly going to take. Plus, looks like means blue-red is open. And all right, Forbidden Alchemy or Fire Ice. Forbidden Alchemy is not great if you're not splashing. It is playable even if you only have black mana and I already have an Expanse. Fire Ice just super solid. Cheaper, lets you cycle through your deck. I think this one's kind of close. Forbidden Alchemy is kind of nice because it puts cards in the graveyard for cards like Treasure Cruise, for instance, gives you cards to delve. I think this is somewhat of a close pick. I don't especially want to have to splash black, even if I already have an Expanse. I think I'm just going to stick to Fire Ice. So you've got Cathodian, which is playable. You've got Foil, which is playable. The Generator Servant, probably not in blue-red, pretty bad. Stitch Rake is actually reasonable. I don't think blue-red can really support more than one Stitch Drake, but having the first one can be good. So I think this is between Stitch Drake and Foil. Foil has been decent for me. And I could see Foil being good with the Summoner, just protect your Summoner. I think I'm actually going to take my first Foil over the first Stitch Drake. Very likely I can get a Stitch Drake later in the draft if I need one. All right, so here we have Crusader, which is usually not playable in blue-red. You usually don't want to be playing Reckless Charge in blue-red, but sometimes end up having to, and it's not the worst thing in the world. Crusader's pretty strong. I'm just going to take Molten Rebirth here. Really good cards with Young Pyromancer and Alchemist, especially if you're lucky and just start winning flips. I can take Great Bombardment here, just in case I end up with some weird version of the deck. I've never played Raid Bombardment yet. It's more of a mono red card. You just pick as many Molten Rebirths as you can and Crusaders and Reckless Charge and then finish people off with Bombardment. Skullkeeper could be serviceable depending on the deck. I'm gonna take Raid, but I think taking Skullkeeper might actually be better. Everything tabled. None of these cards are for me. I'm just gonna send the signals and do all rare drafting. And the Shred Freak's not especially playable in blue red. Maybe mono red. Maybe red black. I'm not too sure. I haven't played with this card yet, or almost had no one cast that card against me either. You had Modern Rebirth in red. You've got Satyr Wayfinder in green. You've got some one power guys that make you feel pretty bad about the freak. Scuzz back. I like to call that card my mythic uncommon. It's just That's really solid common, honestly. 5-2 trample, persist. Super solid. And yeah, I mean, my blue cards are very good, but I've got like two reavers to bombardment, so we'll see. If somehow blue completely dries out, I could see myself just playing the crazy red decks. Wow. Balefire Dragon. I haven't seen that card yet. 6/6 flying for 7. When it deals combat damage to a player, it deals that much damage to each creature that player is controlling. Jesus Christ. That's a card. Alright, if we're ignoring the rare, it would be pretty easy. Faithless Looting, first pick. I'm assuming I should probably play the Mythic Dragon. Just a hunch. Alright, Dreamscape Artist, Harrow Spell Shaper. Not especially good in blue-red. In some blue-green decks, it can be okay. You've got Penumbra Orm, which is just super solid on common when you're playing green. Lots of deck have trouble dealing with it. And as for us, I'm just going to take the Mad Prophet. Solid common. Looting effect. It's a classic and limited, right? Looting effect are almost... Looters are almost always good. And he's no exception, especially with all the madness delve action going on. Ooh, Blast of Genius. Blast of Genius and not much else. Full Fulminator Mage. Unfortunately, the foils on Magic Online are just work the same as the regular cards, and Fulminator Mage probably not worth much. Whereas I'm assuming in real life that card would be probably pretty expensive. Anyways, the pick for us is Blast of Genius. Choose any target, draw 3 cards, then discard a card, deal that much damage. Good finisher, removal spell. Only has one target, so they can fizzle. If you target one of the creatures and they manage to sack it or respond for something, you won't draw. You won't resolve the effect. So Urban Evolution would be a decent splash card, but I don't want to go down that route, especially because there's an Anger in the pack. And Anger has been pretty impressive. I don't remember it being super, super good last time I was around. Like, maybe you played, but nothing exciting. I've been pretty happy with Anger in these blue-red decks. All right. So I said in my article, I like to have at least a copy of Turn to Mist, especially if I can't get just the win, the bounce spell, the madness bounce spell, just to deal with auras. Kind of big creatures, etc. Turn to Mist is way worse than just the wind, but it is serviceable. I could also just take another Molten Rebirth, but I don't have any Thermal Alchemist yet, so kind of worried. But Molten Rebirth just always solid. I think I'm just gonna take another Molten Rebirth. All right. Don't really want a second foil. I've played 2 foils before and it was okay. I think Mystic Retrieval is a bit expensive. It gets better, I think, when you have a lot of looting effects. Yeah, I'm starting to wonder if I shouldn't just go like maybe mono red, maybe mono red slash blue. Yeah, I'm not sure Mystic Retrieval is super important anyways. I might just take Crusader just in case. Just a little hedge, I guess. Yeah, these decks are pretty weak. I wonder if I'm getting a cut or they're just nothing. Iguana are kind of good with all the tokens, I guess. It's a lot of free drops. I guess Bombardment's not really a free drop. Alright, I'll take the Iguana R. Another Vapors, Stitcher Supplier. I mean, maybe Stitcher's Apprentice. I mean, maybe that card's decent in the Raid Bombardment deck. I'll take that. I'll take another Crusader. And I've played Defy Gravity before just because it's like two spells in one card, a bit of value as looters, and in this deck with Crusaders, it could be good. Obviously, you'd rather have Reckless Charge. The Shred Freak, maybe it's good. It's not just a Shred Freak. And another one. And a foil. Yeah, I'm not too sure. Let's see. Let's do a quick head count. One, two. What if I want to be mono red? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And if I want to be blue-red, I have kind of 14 decent cards, maybe play a second foil, I guess. Another Iguanar. Sorry about hope it's not too bad, the swallowing noise and stuff. It is winter. Everyone's a bit, I don't even feel sick or anything. I guess it's just, you wake up, maybe a bit of a stuffy nose. Anyways, apologies. Ooh, Entomb. Entomb's super sweet. If you can get, I think I would gladly start a draft with Entomb in this format. You've got Unburial Rites at Uncommon, you've got Resurrection at Common, you've got another Resurrection at Uncommon that's instant speed and it's called Miraculous Recovery. Anyways, pretty crappy pack for us. Spark Spitter has been pretty solid for me, but I have zero mana cards. It will end up being decent if I play that red deck, but I already have so many free drops. Archaeomancer is a solid as well if I end up blue red. Honestly, I think the Spark Spitter might table anyways. Also, Think Twice could be good, but yeah, it's like kind of not the greatest. Alright, I think I kind of just want to take Archaeomancer. If I end up blue-red, I think Archaeomancer is going to be good for me. And if I end up mono-red, I think I'll have enough cards. Alright, so we got an Aether Snipe, that's really good. We can also play mono-red small blue splash. I'll see. I think the Raid Bombardment will probably table. I mean, I guess maybe I should just go. I mean, the blue-red deck I've played a lot, and I think you probably get the gist of it. Just take that bombardment and see what happens. Just commit, try and get some reckless charges, etc. Aether's not ace, so I'm just gonna take his bombardment on the table. Alright, I'm just gonna commit to bombardment. I haven't played that archetype yet, so that'll be good. Another Anger or a Spark Spitter. As I said, no mana cards. Spark Spitter has been good for me. It was a couple of Reckless Worms, a couple of Fiery Temper, but I don't think it's going to be good in this deck. Karna is a strong splash, but I already have kind of a strong splash. I have two Fire Ice and a Blast of Genius. Frantic Search is usually really good and hard to get your hands on because almost every blue combination wants the card. But as I said, I have no mana cards. Do not know what to take here. Is looting gonna be any good? The first looting's probably gonna be decent. Frantic Search. How many Crusaders do I have? Two and no way to target them? What are my options? Looting, Frantic Search. I think this is it. I'm just going to take Looting. If you're blue-red spells, Frantic Search I think is much better. I guess I do have the two Angers I forgot about. Third Anger? Why not? We'll see. Yeah, I think someone must have been, or sometimes the packs are just weird in this format. It is definitely possible packs are weird. So Deranged Assistant's pretty good in some decks. I usually don't play it in blue red, but this blue red deck would be kind of expensive, so it might actually be good in this version of blue red. Think Twice is fine. Archimancer is fine. No red cards. I'm not too sure. Maybe just Think Twice. Furnace Celebration. That doesn't do anything for me, does it? Rally the Peasants would be a really good splash card, actually. Maybe I just take Rally the Peasants, because I already have Eluding and a Prophet. Any other ways, if I end up mono-red, to discard the Rally the Peasant just for the flashback value? I have an experience, so I can play like one Plains. I don't think you want too many Faceless Lootings anyways. Wow, that's a late Mongrel. That's crazy. Mongrel would be pretty good. Red-green, yeah, I really don't know what I'm gonna do, honestly. I think the Sparks Fitter for now. Because I have these two Crusaders and no way to target them. My deck's really kind of awkward. Huh. Interesting. So, yeah. Lots of playables, lots of deck building is going to be fun. I have no clue. So for blue-red, yeah, we really don't have that. I mean, Talaran's really strong, I guess. That's our incentives for blue-red. Last week, Moan of the Unallowed is... In a real draft, I'd probably just counter-draft Moan of the Unallowed, but... Whatever, I've passed so many. That card's pretty solid. It goes in, works well in really any black-color combination. And let's pick the warrior. Alright, let's see it. Yeah, it's kind of unfortunate because I didn't get my hands on Terminal Alchemist for the blue-red deck, despite a 4th or 5th pick Young Pyromancer in pack 1, so things were looking really great. And I didn't get Reckless Charge either to make my Crusaders good, so... Let's see, the red deck, what would the red deck look like? I would be flashing like one Plains, maybe a couple Plains. Could do like one Plains, one Island, maybe. Two Plains, two Islands. Maybe one Plains, one Island. Was the double, the all the double red cards. So that's 27. Maybe I just don't play the Crusaders. I can tab them with ice if I draw my blue, that's it. I think this deck's kind of bad. Just because I don't have the early drops. Yeah, I'm just gonna go with blue red. Let's see, so I don't need the Crusaders, I don't need the clutches, I don't need the regular shrieks. Do I have enough cards if I'm blue-red? Hope so. It's 18. I guess I can play kind of a hybrid. I mean, Skullkeeper is really not very good. Spark Spitter was anger, kind of Nonbo. I could just play the Higuanars, I guess. Kind of an aggressive blue-red deck. Aggressive-ish blue-red deck. Play the let's make a little maybe pile. Nightbird clutches do anything for me? Nightbird clutches is kind of solid card. You can target your own guy, so if you're like red green heroic or white red heroic or trigger crusaders. Let's see. Yeah, maybe I just play two drops. Maybe Apprentice is good with all the Molten Rebirth. Like, I could have even get my hand on more Scuzzback Marauders. The packs were really weird. I would have been, with all these angers, I would have been pretty happy with two, maybe even a third Scuzzback Marauder, like anything really. These packs were so weird. Instead, I got like 16 Spark Spitters. And I haven't played Skywing even in Blue Red yet. I don't like that it's only two power for free mana. And just, I don't know, whenever I've played against it, it always seemed like underwhelming. Maybe the third anger. Not that great in my deck, but I'll try one Stitcher's Apprentice. I haven't played that card much. Let's see if it can at least be, obviously it's not gonna be great, but maybe it can be serviceable. And last card, Skywing Aven. I think I have enough two drops. I guess I'll just play Skywing Aven. I could play 18 lands too, but I have a bunch of cantrips. In my deck, I mean, I have a couple expensive cards, but it's not that expensive. All right, I'll just try Aven, I guess. I'm not crazy about it. And then, is it gonna be 8 and 8? Yeah, 8 and 8 sounds right. All right, this is it. So we'll see. We'll see what we can do. All right. Round one. Let's see. Yeah, I'll keep. Hand doesn't look great, but to be honest, to be fair, like is not the best either, so not sure if I can hope for much better. Guess looting turn one probably does discard both angers. Oh, I couldn't see the expanse for a second. I was like, did I misclick that? Okay, white red. White red heroic. Let's see, beat down against beat down. Let's see if I can win some flips with Molten Rebirth. Usually pretty good. I have a strategy. I always snap call heads. It usually works 50% of the time, every time. That's super scary. I have two Fire Ice. I think my deck's very well equipped to deal with Linkseed Rider. Alright, definitely play Iguanar here. Given that I have Tataran, I want to save the spells for after Talonrun. Yeah, I only drafted Talonrun once before. I was blue red. I was kind of, it was one of my one of free blue red cards. So it's kind of, or free blue cards. So it's kind of awkward. It was the mana. I'm not even sure I drew it a single time or cast a single time. All right, that's a good news. Nothing's targeted the Wingseed Rider. So that's good for us. They're swinging. Let's see. So my options. I really only have one reasonable option, is to just play the Talonrun, I think. Doesn't have flying itself. Not sure that the attack's good, actually. They're just gonna block and take one. That's kind of pretty mediocre attack. Oh well. Yeah, not great. To be fair, if I don't attack, I don't especially want to block either. So I guess forcing the trade's not a bad thing. Oh, wow. That is backbreaking. Helix, it's your gold on common when you're a white red. You get Helix, you get Rally the Peasants too. These are kind of the two uncommons pay off. So 2/1 and a 2/2. Let's play Archimancer, seems kind of reasonable. Playing Molten Rebirth too. Play Archaeomancer this turn, I can go Pyromancer plus looting next turn. I can never get to 7 mana before I die. Scuzzback, Molten Rebirth. Yeah, I have a few cards on. I think this is pretty good. Also, just trades with an athlete, they need to have a. Something to target. They're down to 2 cards, 3 wizard draw steps. The way they've been playing, it doesn't seem like they have anything that really targets. I mean, if they had a Reckless Charge, they probably would have Reckless Charge Wingseed Rider a very long time ago. Oh. So, yeah, I was talking about during the draft. You want to make sure you get your hands on a turn to miss, at least, or ideally a just a win or two. I was not able to do that. And yeah, looks like that's just gonna be the game. I don't think I have any outs. And Pyro doesn't deal with flyers. I have a Skywing even in my deck, but I don't know how I win by I basically have to block every turn with Skywing Aven, hope they draw nothing, and get to 6 mana, but then even then they have a blocker. I'm pretty sure I can scoop. Alright. Even if I do get there, they still have like a blocker. I have no outs, right? I'm just gonna scoop. Full Molten Reverse. Alright. I didn't get my hand on turn to mist. I had a blast, but no, blast just way too late. I kind of want to go bombardment against them. I think it might make sense. The reason being, they have a lot of one toughness guys. Aggro versus aggro. My blue cards are pretty good though. The dragon just seems so expensive too. I'm gonna try the mono-red version on the play. Let's see it. Put all the angers, spark spitters, crusaders, bombardment, clutch. Add lands. Are you still on 17 lands? Add the plains. 8, 9, 10, 11. 15. 1 plains, 1 island, 17 mountains. Too many cards right now. I didn't even get all the bombardments in. Yeah, just don't play Crusader. And blast. No, I don't know about the dragon. Feel like it's bad, but it is a freaking dragon. All right, I'll keep the dragon in. It's not like I have anything super exciting to play over the dragon, so like another spark spitter would probably be it. One land hand, one land looting, double anger, double reverse. I'm gonna keep. I don't know if it's mathematically sound, but it seems fine. I don't think this deck's gonna mulligan very well either. So I'll gamble. Oh, like four draw steps, draw two lands. All right, what do we get? Plains or island? Probably be pretty happy with the fire part of fire and ice against their deck. So I think I'm just gonna go with plains. Oh, Terminal Alchemist. I think Terminal Alchemist is usually very good in the white red decks. But I mean, it's a two drop. It's like a solid card. Right, snap heads. I even know where it is. It's on the left. Wow, I lost. Wow. Rigged. Oh. Give me a second. Sorry about that. It was my wife. Can't really ignore my wife. I have to at least pick up. Good thing is zero power, so I can keep attacking and dealing damage with bombardment against them. Let's see, what's the deal here? Or just make coupled guys and say go. Yay! Alright, obviously I don't think it's worth trading one creature just for two damage, especially with raid in hand. Multiple raid stacks too. What about, nah, that's a lot of damage. I think I go Molten Rebirth again. And I think I just go clutch. I and get in for 6. So the thing about these red decks is I don't think there's too many lifelink cards. There's Mark of the Vamp in black, but that card I've almost never seen played. Might not be bad though, but there's Reviving Vapors in blue-white and Ancestors Chosen in blue-white. But yeah. Or maybe I messed up. Maybe I was supposed to not play Clutches. I don't know if it's gonna matter. Oh, that's a good draw. Just in case. Are they dead? 6? No, they're not. I think I'm one short. So I'm just gonna kill the flyer. It would be like 6 damage plus 4 unblocked. That's 10 plus 2. I'd put them down to 1. To be fair, your draw didn't seem that good, and I might have just won with a regular blue-red draw. Not too sure. Not sure what I'm supposed to do on the draw now. Now that I've lost was the blue-red version of the deck, and one was the... I mean, their draw was so much worse. Their draw was so much worse. You can also just play Raid Bombardment in the blue-red deck. It doesn't have to be, like, just a mono-red card. Should I show them the second one? I'll just play the Clutches. Not sure, not give them too much info. I don't think there's much they can have. God's Willing, sure. It's converted mana cost 2 or less, not power 2 or less, so I don't get anything back. Okay. The Helix. Why didn't they kill a token before attacking though? They took 1 damage for nothing. It actually lived 1 more turn. Alright, so if they had exactly God's Willing and Helix, they got to live 1 more turn. And I still probably won pretty easily next turn, but yeah, I guess I should definitely be playing Raid Bombardment. Whether I'm blue-red or not, the card's just... I mean, I did draw 2 Molten Rebirth, and I won my flip, and I had Anger. The blue is just kind of clunky. I wonder if Crusader is good against them. Just 1-1 for 1 was a tiny, tiny, tiny upside. Balefire Dragon just seems like a pipe dream. Seems like the games are way too fast for Balefire Dragon. And I have a bunch of loot effects. Am I really gonna cut Balefire Dragon and add like Sparks Fit or something? Crusader, how do I target you? Nightbird's Clutches. I mean, 1-1 for 1 when you're playing a bunch of raids and iguana and stuff is not that bad. I'm gonna do it so I can punish myself too. When I draw the Crusader and it could have been a dragon. On 17 lands. I have 1 profit, 1 looting to discard excess lands. It's pretty cheap. Alright, I'm just gonna do... I'm just gonna play good old 1-1 for 1. exactly what you shouldn't be playing in limited. 1-1 for ones. Well, looking better than a dragon for now. Ooh, I even draw the prophet. One toughness creature. Damn it. That is not good, not good at all. Let's see. Do I offer a trade? I mean, they can kill the bombardment if they want to. Can block kill. I'm not gonna offer the trade. This game's not looking great. The Wingseed Rider just. I needed a fire. If I had a fire this game, it'd probably be easy. Just kill a rider. Make a 1-1 and they have like no pressure. GG. Yeah. I literally didn't see a single bounce spell in the draft. Hyena Umbra post combat, huh? Seems like slight misplay. All right, Mad Prophet, gonna have to work overtime here. I'm gonna end up losing because this is not a dragon. I would get there. I'd probably get there. Three turns. I don't know. We'll see. I like how they did the shame thing where they don't play armor on their turn when they have one white up. Why would you? Oh, they have God's Willing in hand. I get it. Man, they have God's Willing on top of everything. All right, I can still win. I just need to draw Anger and a Molten Rebirth. Here's Molten Rebirth. Now I need Anger. It's not an Anger. Bit late. Huh. So, can play Molten Rebirth, play my land, end of turn, fire something. Alright, I'm gonna start by playing Molten Rebirth. That's not good. I can kill Pilgrim, attack with everything. It's not great. Alright, I'll just say go for now. I think I'm just gonna fire the Pilgrim in off turn. Man, if that Unicorn was just a 2-2, it's vanilla 2-2, you're not gonna play, but it's kind of brutal. Maybe they just don't realize? I don't know. Alright, I'm just gonna fire the Pilgrim, I guess. I could gamble that they F6 somehow, but they have God's Willing in hand, so they probably have an F6. And like, fire the Ronum Unicorn and they don't... That'd be kind of gaming mode, I guess. Not very honorable. The good thing is they need to sag the Unicorn. Oh wow. Oh wow. Four? Five, six, seven? Plus 14? That's actually 20. The question is... And I guess I should loot first, even though they're gonna know about it. Oh, that was an absurd draw. I mean, if they have nothing, they're dead. Alright, they did not mess up, unfortunately. I don't think they have a Helix either. This is not a sorcery, right? Thank God. I didn't think it was, but... I mean, that's 21 if I did the math right. Okay, it did have the... Wow, it's kind of crazy that I didn't kill Prophet before. Alright, I need to dodge the Umbra. Oh no, the Umbra doesn't kill me. For some reason, I thought the Umbra was lethal. The Umbra is not lethal. It would only be 8 damage. Alright, I think we're gonna have 2 draw steps. 2 draw steps for bombardment. This is it. Does anger do it? No, anger leaves me 1 short. Spark Spitter. Do I have anything that costs 6? I'm trying to think if I should discard Sparks. I mean, I'm dead anyway. Sparks Spitter is not going to do anything. Alright, this is it. Block 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, no, anger was actually lethal. First strike, vigilance, blah, blah, blah. Target my guys. I have nothing in my graveyard. Could draw the redraw, the looting redraw, I guess. Looting. Sparks fit. Come on, bombardment. Be there. Sigh. Alright, GG's. That was unfortunate. If I win the flip, I think I win the game. Through like 9 lands. Alright. Oh, so close. They don't have Helix. I win. Alright. Alright, I decided to edit the deck. In same way I've I've played it in game 2 and 3 of round 1. Figured it looked a bit better and just do I let them ramp? I kind of want to get that value. It's like bolting the bird though. Free arrow. No, I'm gonna go for damage and token and let them have their arrow. Yeah, it looked, honestly, it looked pretty solid. And my blue-red, if I had a good blue-red deck, I think I would go with blue-red every day, but yeah, that my deck's pretty mediocre. Uh-oh. They gambled and they lost. Out of their own ice. Might as well fire. Yeah, and I talked about that archetype in my article, the red Molten Rebirth of Mardin, but I've actually never played it before, so that's cool too. All right, well, this game is obviously dumb because their mana is screwed, and I don't believe there's a sweeper. There's rolling. That's not true. There's rolling. I think it's called Rolling Tumbler. Red and two. Never seen anyone cast that card, but it's definitely reasonable. Yeah, sure. Why not? So I could get to attack with my Pyromancer and not lose a creature. I wonder what their second color is. Could be red, could be kind of blue-green five color deck. Who knows, the Dreamscape artist. Was it? Rebuilding the deck, and I was actually thinking about gamble. I don't believe it's good, but gamble for rally the peasant, something like that. Just not reliable enough. Decided to cut Bone Dragon, play one Spark Spitter, but the two Crusader are just so sketchy. All right, hoping for a looting here. Looting would be amazing. I didn't even cast it on turn one, but just later in the game. Recycle these extra lands. All right, so they are blue-red. It's probably gonna get fired. Who knows, maybe not. Yikes. I really need that looting now. Destroying land after land. These are lots of flip. That was huge. They win the flip there. Ugh. Oof. Baby. Baby. Kind of play it as a 2-2 the anger. Just discard two lands. Good old value anger. Speaking of value, I'll play bombardment now. This way when I attack with anger next turn they take damage. Or do I play spark spitter? To have a blocker. I'm gonna try to max out on damage, but it's definitely questionable. Let's hope they don't have, if they don't have too much removal in their deck, I might be okay. If they just play a bunch of creatures, like the creatures in blue red are usually not very big, so they might just be in a rough spot dealing with my stupid synergies. It's a lot of card advantage. Okay. Anger. So I have looting. Do I want to play my land? I think I do. Because I kind of want to go Spark Spit or Raid Bombardment next turn if I draw a land. I think I could use... I think I'm going to be happy. I don't know. I do have a Spark Spitter in hand. Oof, it's tough. So the extra lands are going to be good with that. I might be a bit too slow. I'll play it. I have a Scuzzback Marauder too. I have one card that costs 5, so I might need a fifth land at some point. Wow, they did not choose Mad Prophet. That is scary as hell. I mean, honestly, Assault is strong, but when you already have a Mad Prophet in hand, you make good use of these extra lands. Life from the Loam? What was that? Oh, Cathodian. All right, this is looking tough. Kind of falling behind here. That profit's not even that good right now. I guess I just play Spark Spitter and say go. I basically need to draw Molten Rebirth. That's another reason to play the extra land to try to get to 6 mana. Yeah. Alright, I managed to stop their attacks. So that's something. I don't think I want to attack just for 2 damage. Rid of Runesnag. I guess at this point they might be valuing land over Runesnag. Aether Snipe. A lot of damage. How much damage is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have Assault and... Yeah, I mean, I'm super dead, but... Yeah, I'm just dead on board. Just to see if I win the flip. Yeah, I mean... That's a good curve stuff. Do I want fire into? Just curved out decently. I think I'll be fine on the play though. Should be just fine. I'm assuming the green splash is for Life from the Loam. Could be Pulse of Marasa too. Like Pulse, Archaeomancer, that kind of stuff. I'm not too sure. All right. Fire Eyes probably one of my best cards. Happy to have them in my opener. It's kind of a sick spot. I mean, if I play Iguana and that Fire Ice, I just lose. Alright, I'm just gonna tap their land. I might be giving up so much damage, but it's definitely questionable. If I play Iguana and they don't have anything, I probably just run them over. They could have Runesnag too, actually. Now that I think about it. Yeah, I like my play. If you factor in Runesnag, makes it a bit better of play, I think. I'm just gonna play Anger. Just value Anger. It's really good against Runesnag too. What you gonna do, just counter it? Okay. Now it seems like if I ever draw anything like a Molten Rebirth or just so much damage. Alright, I mean they could still have Fire Ice, not a Rune Snag. Alright. That's gonna fire. Push some damage through. Was Anger in the yard and double bombardment. Plus they were playing a color combo that doesn't get rid of enchantments. I mean, they could have Elder, I guess. Wicker Bow Elder, like of the green splash. They're not very good with the flip. Bombardment. This guy. Just say go. Yeah, I mean, if I ever draw Molten Reverse, look at Scheme. Blast of Genius. Ugh. I'll play Bombardment first, and if I win the flip, I might attack. I lost. Tag, they go block, block. It's kind of close. Dump 7, I have 1 token left. But if I say go, yeah, no. Much better to wait. Oh, they do have Life from the Loam. Discarded it. Aether Snipe would be pretty backbreaking. Molten Reworked is bad, but at least I don't lose my token, so I get the extra trigger from Bombardment. Oh, they're actually getting aggressive. They must have another blocker. Seems like kind of a disaster to not keep free blockers here. But they probably have fire and ice. Yeah, it's gonna be bad. Oh, Frantic Surge? Oh, Frantic Surge first. Oh, Reckless Swarm. No, why would they do that before I attack if it was Reckless Swarm? Maybe they're digging to fire ice. Oh, Fiery Temper, alright, that makes sense. Alright, it was 2 bombardment in play. I just get in there, get my value before they play Aether Snipe. Wow, looks like I'm gonna lose. This game was looking great. Is the archetype showing its limitation? It's wow. Correct. Well, Fire and Ice and Molten Rebirth both pretty good against my deck. Should I play a land? Probably not. Yeah. That's pretty rough. The only game we won was the game where they just got mana screwed too. It's not even like I won the real game. All right, Aether Stomp is non-permanent. Sick. All right, GG's. Well, I did say during the draft that I didn't think my deck was good and things didn't go well. I don't think the blue-red version of the deck would have done much, much better. I mean, maybe if I can go Talran plus Fold protected, but...
Hey everyone, I'm Luscott Burgess, and I'm actually one of the lead designers on Eternal. Eternal is a digital card game that I've worked on since the beginning, and it's both fast-paced and very deep strategy. It's free to play. You can play it on Xbox, you can play it on Steam, you can play it on iOS, so it's easy to pick up, and you can play whenever you want. I've had a lot of fun with it, and I think you will too.
Alright, won the die roll. Decent hand. I guess, maybe. If I win, it's a decent hand 50% of the time, I guess. And it's a great hand 25% of the time. And it's an amazing hand 12.5% of the time. Iguanar or Molten Rebirth? Just Iguanar. Yeah, I only played against that red Bombardment Rebirth deck once, and I was playing kind of... I had a pretty good blue-white deck with a bunch of life gain effects, but my draw weren't super good, and my opponent drew really well. He also had a good version of the deck. He had... A bunch of Reckless Charge and Crusaders. It just so much damage in the early game. And I have like a bad, kind of a bad version of the deck. Alright. Alright. Maybe I should have played Anger first. Wow. Well, the head's failing me. Failing me on camera. Everyone knows you always call heads. Some people say tails never fail, but... Oh, they have the unicorn again. My worst nightmare. I think I should have actually maybe just hard cast the anger last turn, but now I don't know. Just play the anger and say go. I wonder if I should search for planes right away. What am I really gonna use ice? The ice part of fire ice this game? I could. I'll wait a bit. Probably wondering why I'm playing mono red with an expanse in my deck. Doesn't seem very smart. I just attack with everything and they're not killing. That's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 damage. Kind of want to. What am I waiting for? Please send the anger in. Please send everything but the Iguanar. I'll lose a bunch of creatures, but it's a lot of damage. Yeah, I'll do that before they realize they should be killing bombardment with the unicorn. Let's see. I think it's a good attack. Might get wrecked, but... Plus, I kind of want to get anger in the yard. Gwenar's... I misread it at first. I was like, my opponent played it, and I was like, wow, this card's pretty bad. And then I didn't realize it was both players' creatures. I thought when I read it the first time, I thought it was just their creatures, you know? Even attacks planeswalkers. Anger in the yard with Scuzz back in hand. It's nice. I wonder what they have in hand. Maybe a bunch of tricks. Well, their hand must be good because they're winning to trade an elite for anger instead of just blocking with Mongrel and pumping. Yes. Boggle. Drafted the Boggle once in a white-green deck, but I ended up not playing it. I just didn't have enough. I think putting Umbras on a Boggle is not super exciting. Because Umbras are not big enough. Maybe it is. I don't know. Maybe if you get the Boar Umbra, it could be okay, I guess. Grovewalker? Okay. Sure. Weird. Why are they not playing... Why are they not... Must have some kind of trick. Oh, it's 8 mana. My bad. Yeah, a bit late. Killing that bombardment, I think. I'm assuming Scuzz back is just game. I'm not gonna attack with the Gwenar just in case. Cause if they had a trick, it could go poor. I don't know what trick they could have though. But that's lethal. It's one from the bombardment, two from my guys dying, and one more from one of their guys dying. Scuzz back has trample. Yay! I guess I won game one last round as well. I mean, the matches were kind of close. I see 0-2 is not a great look, but... Balefire Dragon might be good. Problem is Balefire Dragon is... I think I'm supposed to... I don't think I can afford to have just a 7 mana card in my opening hand against them. I thought I'm just going to get ran over. Could see cutting a stupid Crusader though. The Crusader is so good. The upside is so small. I'll just play the dragon. Freaking dragon. The only way Crusader is ever good, I think, is if I draw Nightbird's Clutches. Because I can go like. It's not great, but I can go target my guy, target your guy, get a 1-1, do it again. It does add up, but yeah, not great. All right. Double checking that the mic's not muted. I don't think it's happened to me yet for Channel Fireball that I've just done a whole like round or draft or something muted. Knock on wood, hopefully it never happens. But yeah, even though I'm not doing a lot of winning, I hope I feel like this draft was still kind of interesting. You got to see like what kind of a like bad blue-red deck looks like, and we got to play a bit with the Raid Bombardment archetype and see how, you know, even though I felt like I was drawing pretty good, I felt short that just Fire Ice was good. They had their own Molten Rebirth, Outlaws to Flip, they had cards like Aether Snipe. So I think in my article I wrote that I wasn't sure how good that Raid Bombardment was deck, if you should it was funny because I actually said you know, is it like something you should actively look to draft, or is it more of a fallback plan in case you draft train wrecks? And from what I've seen so far, I would say it's more of B, you know. It's more like, okay, it's a reasonable fallback if your draft really goes poorly, and if you keep getting those Raid Bombardments, like pick 13 or 14. Well, that card just crushes me. Ooh, Scuzzy. Not even gonna attack. Heart's pretty cool. If there was such a thing as a soul, I think it would be behind the gallbladder, but above the kidneys. I mean, they just have to attack. Yeah, that's how they win the matchup. They just erase me. Play a bunch of big dudes. I can attack. They can. And it's kind of a nightmare. Alright, they're going to play Iguana. I think I might just have to block Mongrel if they attack. Hope they don't just have a bunch of madness cards. A little black splash. That's what they had in hand game one. Maybe some black cards. Attack can obviously absolutely never beat that card. Oh, that's gross. I'll attack, and I'll try to set up blocks next turn. Get rid of that bombardment. Yeah, I guess that's another downside of the Monorite archetype. Mark of the Vamp is not your friend. Yeah, I mean, Anger is obviously not very good, but I mean, Raid, we're a long ways from getting value and killing them with Raid Bombardment, so I think maybe just a 2-2 might, could be helpful, you never know. Alright, step one is drawing land, we have... We can actually maybe do something about that Mongrel now. I guess I should have traded Rakdos Shred Freak was Safehold Elite a long time ago. Looks like that's what I'm gonna end up having to do anyways. I need to get into board stall and draw my dragon. That's the plan. Do they have a trick? So that's what it feels like to play against someone who plays slow. They're pumping. Is that just to gain an extra life, or is there... Am I gonna get blown out? I don't think I can get blown out too badly. Huh. I just wanted the extra damage, I guess. Oh, I shouldn't have six. I haven't used Mad Prophet yet. Cancel that F6. I'm gonna discard Anger. Oh, looks like I haven't canceled F6. Why is it not canceled? Oh, they got back Mark of the Vamp. Alright, well, I'm still on the dragon plan, I think, so let's see. Okay, Smolten Reavers, Call Heads, because. Oh. Do I want to cast Looting now? I have one bad card. I guess I need the land. I'm going to save it. Can I attack? Probably not. I'm not in too bad of a shape, honestly. And I have a plan. Like, the game would be much different if I didn't have Dragon in my deck. Without Dragon in my deck, I mean, I have a plan. The plan is hope Looter makes up for the life swings and... hope they flood and I don't get flooded with a Mad Prophet, but I think the dragon in the deck's kind of nice. All hasty dragon. Elder, sure. Elder doesn't do much. Alright. I guess I should have did it first, no. Wow. Well then. I'll just play my Island. I need 7 mana anyways, and... I don't know, it's probably loose to just play it now for no reason. There's no, like, Mind Rot or Ravenous Rats in this set. Not that I know of. There's Liliana of the Veil that makes you discard. Trying to think. I'm sure there's something else. There's gotta be more than just Liliana of the Veil, but... There's not, like, a Burglar Rat, Ravenous Rat, Mind Rot at common, at any rate. Spitter. I was gonna play the Looting now. I have all bad cards except for Dragon, basically. I think I just play defense. Like, his color combo doesn't even have... I guess it can have Crushing Canopy. Which would actually make sense because of Raid Bombardment. That'd be kind of funny if they brought in crushing canopy for raid bombardment and just dealt with my dragon like that. I guess I wish I'd been a bit more patient. Maybe bait crushing canopy with bombardment. Clutches. I was gonna move the clutches away. Who cares? One step closer to my dragon. Hopefully dragon's not the last card in the deck. That'd be kind of brutal. Could have double black now, so they can potentially play Unholy Hunger, but I think black is their splash, so that'd be the case. All right, I'm gonna call heads. Oh! I'm due. Well, yeah, of course I say that. And yeah, I guess looting was a spell in hand, was a Gwenar in hand, not waiting till they had like excess lands. It was a bit greedy. I think it was reasonable. In hindsight, I wish I hadn't. It's a bit greedy and hasty, maybe. I do have one raid bombardment left. Uh-oh, they got a flyer? Oh, I can put Mark of the Vamp on it as well? Yeah, I might end up losing because I had to loot that bombardment away. Maybe I can attack? Oh, wow. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12. All right, I'm just gonna attack with everyone. I didn't do the math, but I have a feeling it's gonna be more than enough. Plus, they're probably gonna lose all their guys. Rally the peasants. If you must go out at night, bring a mob. It's to fight the werewolves. No, it's bombardment. I'm done. Bombardment doesn't do anything. It's elder. They did have the elder. Oh, they're letting all that through. I don't know. Billion damage incoming. There is a fog. There's Dawn. Dawn of Charm. They have Dawn of Charm. It's good beats. GG, as we say. That'd be a blowout. Hey, we won a match. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed it. I might do some more UMA drafts before GP Prague in Vancouver. I'll see what Andy thinks, but yeah. Make sure you give the Channel Fireball YouTube channel a follow or subscribe if you haven't done that yet. And if you wanna see me play more Magic, I stream daily on Twitch. twitch.tv/yellowhat, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Take care, and I'll see you next time.